Hi, I'm Christian. Hello and welcome to the fifth episode of our developer series. In the previous episodes, we took a look at the Controlix core and we talked about the Controlix device portal. But today is programming time. That is why I've invited Johannes once again. Most of you will know him from episode 3, where we talked about the Controlix data layer. So welcome, Johannes.
Hi, Christian. Thanks for inviting me again.
And it won't be the last time. What are you going to share with us today?
Today I want to show you all about the software development kit, our SDK.
What is the software development kit? What do I need it for? And what was your role in it?
Okay, the software development kit is needed for example, our customers to integrate their own know-how in our Controlix automation ecosystem. And the software development kit contains, for example, some libraries to develop your own app. And my role was basically to develop it from the beginning.
So from the greenfield to the finished product.
You could put it that way.
As far as I know, SDK is not common if you look at other controls on the market.
Definitely, because control systems usually run with proprietary software, which is not open for third party.
And that is different with us.
Yes, this is completely different with us. With Controlix Automation, we develop an open system, and with the SDK, we enable other software developers like me to program their own apps and extend the functionalities.
When you talk about openness, we're very quickly back to the topic of security. We will have a dedicated episode on that, but maybe you can tell already a little bit about how the SDK can provide increased security.
That's very simple. Each developer has to deal with the security standards himself, but we have documentation in the SDK that shows how to integrate your app into our system and use all the security mechanisms.
For example, license and user management?
For all of these, we have examples in the SDK that allow developers to benefit from our highest security standards.
This sounds all very comfortable, but what is all included in our kit?
The good news for all the developers, it's a very common SDK that you will be familiar with immediately. Here we have a collection of tools, libraries, documentation, and code snippets that you are able to contribute your own app into the Controlix world.
Okay, but first things first, how can I get the SDK or where can I download it?
You can download the SDK via the Controlix Automation community. Let me show this real quick.
Okay, please.
So, if you go to our Controlix Automation community, in the App Zone, you find the Controlix Automation SDK. And there you are able to download it. And if you ask yourself how to set up a system, we also have some how-to videos to set up your VirtualBox, for example, or how to build in Snap.
Thank you very much. But now let's have a look into the SDK.
Already there. If you unpack the SDK, you see these folders. For example, there is some documentation or our samples for C++ and the samples for Go. If you open the documentation, you have for each sample an own documentation. Just let me show how easy it is to write an own data provider. Let's take a look in the source code to register a new data provider to our Controlix data layer.
Yes, please.
Here I open my Visual Studio Code as IDE and set up a WSL as development environment before. All our sample projects are CMake based and can be compiled here out of the box. This example registers 4 new data providers to our Controlix data layer. And we have created some build tasks to build the whole project completely, and it's very easy to use. So I just run one of these build tasks and create our first snap for our Controlix Core Virtual, for example. After your build task runs successfully, you have your own snap created. So let's install this snap to our Controlix Core Virtual and see how it works to register the data provider to our Controlix data layer. So I do this really quick. After we create our first application successfully, we can install it in our virtual control. I switch to it and then I can log in. Now I go to the packet manager and install it from the local storage. I upload the app before and prepared the control. So now I install it. When I install the app successfully, I switch back to the operation mode. Let's take a look in our ControlX data layer. So if you look here, you see my data, and under my data, there are four new data providers, which provide some sample data. I can change the values, for example. Now you see the values changed.
Cool. A short question. Maybe a lot of people out there will be interested as well. When does it make sense to write a new data provider?
Yeah, it makes sense if you want to provide your own data to the ControlX data layer and to the whole system. For this, we have a code snippet to create your own provider.
Okay. Then you write your code, you compile it, you pack it as a snap, and then you install it on your control.
That's the way it goes. We can modify here our values of the register data providers directly in the data layer tree, or we provide some additional sample to work with the data layer from client side. So I go back to my Visual Studio Code and open our other sample called Data Layer Client. But you have already seen how to build a snap. So let's debug this little application.
Sure.
So we can change the value of our registered sample string to developer, for example. Let's save it and build and run the application. And after that, we can debug it. Now let's debug the application. You see, I set a breakpoint before we change the value. Let's go to this breakpoint. Here, the debugger is attached. We step over. And now let's go back in the data layer tree. We see the string values changed.
Looks easy.
Yes, of course it is.
Another question. Do you need the SDK to integrate your own code?
Not necessarily. You can also create your own apps without the SDK, but actually it makes no sense.
Because then you're without our security features, right?
That is one thing. And if you want to communicate directly with our ControlX data layer without the REST interface, you have to use our ControlX data layer library, which is part of the SDK.
And then programming is really fun.
Yes, because you can be successful very easily.
And to a certain extent, this is also due to our multilingualism, right?
Good point. I also want to mention it because that differentiates us from the market.
You just showed us some samples in C++. Is this the only language we speak and understand?
No. Currently, you can develop your app in C, C++, or even in Go. Other languages like Python are planned for deep integration.
But this is rather unusual, right?
Yes, but it makes sense because the developers can solve their problem which fits best for their use case.
Can you give me an example?
Well, C++ is optimal for high-performance applications. That's why we developed our automation core in C++. Python, for example, fits best for machine learning. And when we thought which language would be best to program the device admin snap, we benchmarked different languages.
And which one was the winner?
Amazingly, Go. Also, we had least experience with it.
Exciting. What a big step. Especially when you think about how limited we used to be with classical PLC programming languages.
Sure, that was a decision for the future. The programming languages are constantly developing and you have to stay up to date. As a developer, you have your favorite language, but you have to be open for modern languages.
And as you well know, it will become more and more difficult to hire classical PLC programmers. The next generations, I think they will be used to high-level programming languages.
Right, they're used to languages like Python and Go.
And with our system, they could start immediately with a language they like to.
depending on whether the machine builder specifies a language. But in any case, we are open for everything.
What a nice conclusion. So the SDK allows you, firstly, to implement your own know-how, secondly, in the language of your choice, and 100% integrated to the system. This means every developer can work with the system in the way he's familiar with. So no other system on the market can offer this.
That's exactly how it is.
First of all, thank you, Johannes, for giving us an insight into the SDK. And we will see you again. In the next episode, which will be available on November 19th, we will show you how to integrate partner apps with the help of the SDK. I hope we could answer all of your questions, and I'm looking forward to your comments on the SDK. So follow us and catch you on the next one to be two steps ahead.